To graph this cubic function, what we're going to do first is identify the basic graph and then the translations. So the basic graph here is x cubed. Okay, the next thing I notice is that I have a reflection. You always want to do your reflections first. So negative x cubed, we're going to think of it as a reflection about the x-axis. Okay, and then finally we have a vertical translation up 1 unit. So negative x cubed, the plus 1 tells me to shift then the entire graph up 1 unit. Okay, so we're ready to graph this. Okay, so let's first graph that basic function. When I plug in 0, I get 0. When I plug in 1, I get 1. 2 will be 8. Negative 1 will be negative 1. And when I plug in x equals negative 2, I'll get a negative 8 for the y value. So let's go ahead and plot the, sketch the basic graph. Well, let's sketch it with a dotted line. Okay, and that'll look something like this. F of x equals x cubed. Okay, now let's look at the reflection. When you reflect this about the x-axis, certainly the origin would stay the same, and this point would get reflected to 1, negative 1. This point here would get reflected to negative 1, comma 1. Okay, so the reflection would look something like that. Okay, so here you see the graph of negative x cubed. Okay, and then finally we're going to do a vertical translation. We're going to shift that entire graph up 1 unit. So let's follow all the points. This point we get shifted up 1 unit, 1 unit, and also here 1 unit. So let's go ahead and connect those dots. Okay, and that would be a rough sketch of the original function, negative x cubed plus 1, using translations.